Close your eyes, baby.
Papa got us up so early this morning. The bad man had come. Mommy said we should have gone earlier, but Papa said he was the only doctor in the village. He couldn't go. It was so scary. There were lots of men in green with funny-looking bandanas and shaved heads. Mommy told me to be brave. I cried a little in the back of the truck. Papa held on to me. I could hardly breathe. Don't squeeze me so hard, Papa.
It's okay, baby. It's gonna be okay.
We arrived at dawn. Steel gray sky. Cold rain. We took them all away. Old folks. Young moms holding onto their kids. We just shoved them all in the truck. The houses of the Muslims had been marked and burned. Something way in the back of my mind, like a whisper, murmured, "Stop! What are you doing?" I am just following orders. I pick up a doll that this little girl dropped. She reaches for it. The sergeant takes it, rips its head off, and spits at the girl. I walk away.
Don't be afraid, baby. Don't be afraid.
The ride was so long, and I was so scared. My mommy was praying, and I could hear crying and people talking real soft. My papa held me in his arms and told me a story about a princess. The truck stopped, and the bad men pulled us out. I fell and hurt my arm.
The whole way there, I gripped onto my gun and hoped nobody would see my fear. Could I do this? Kill people? Could I? Why couldn't I just go home? I want to go home, please, please. The truck stops suddenly. Then I'm swept away. The sergeant yells at us. I move. I follow orders. Old folks, moms holding onto their kids, are lined up at the edge of the pit. We stand in a row.
Close your eyes, baby.
Afterward, I just stand there. God, it's cold. Someone lights a cigarette. I puke. My sergeant laughs and kicks me. I walk over to the pit and look down. A small body torn apart. Tiny hands clutch at her father. God, what have I done? Now I know there is a hell. I walk its streets every day.